number of eminent scholars in modern times have written books on Bhagavad Gita, and some excellent versions are available in English. However, no translation of Gita could bring the dignity and beauty of the original version. Its melody, because it is in a musical form, and the magic phrase are very difficult to capture in a commentary. Yet, actually the commentaries are on Gita were written by very famous acharyas. Sri Shankaracharya, Sri Ramanujacharya, Sri Madhvacharya, they have written commentaries in support of their own tradition, Sampradaya. I wish to discuss Gita Bhashya of Sri Ramanuja. He starts the Gita Bhashya with salutations to his predecessor Sri Yamanacharya, and then he follows it up with glorious descriptions of Lord Narayana's attributes. He says the purpose of incarnation of Narayana was to relieve the burden of the earth. Not only that, equally important is a lesson to be available for the common men and women and give them an opportunity actually to own eyes and take refuge, surrender to him. This is how he starts in Gita Bhashya. The actual commentary actually starts with Arjuna surveying the Kaurava army when he saw his grandfather Bhishma, teachers, cousins, friends. Forcing him, he was grief-stricken. He saw that the war would lead to ruin of the entire clan of Kuru Vamsa, perishing the ancient values also. Then he threw his Khandiva and sat down, overwhelmed with the emotion, with the grief, and he saw a great sin actually in waging war, and lost all the desire. This is where he is resolving actually, he is abstaining from his duty as a Kshatriya duty. And as a leader born out of he was under a false notion that it's only the body, the Prakriti, and the destruction of the body amounts to the destruction of the entire man as he is known. This false notion can be removed by the knowledge of the truth about oneself. And the truth is, only essential truth is the Atman. And Sri Ramanuja refers to it as Brahman. According to Vasishtadvaita school, the realities are two, actually three: Supreme Being, Chit, Prakriti, Achit. The individual soul, the Atman, is Anu. He says is Anu in the Ramanuja system. Its individuality is not lost even in a liberal state when it is liberated. In the liberated state, actually its attribute of consciousness actually becomes fully extended and has no obstructions at all. And that Atman becomes a Vibhu, he says, unlimited. And in this sense is Brahman. So, commenting on Gita, Anadi Matparam Brahma Asat Tan Nasat Ukayet. See, Ramanuja himself gives the justification in interpreting Brahman as Atman. Matpara, that means one with me, that is one with Ishvara, as once Brahman as Atman. The one here is refers to as Atman, and Atman who is a Sesha of Ishvara. He is a Sesha, means he is a servant, he is a slave of Ishvara. There is no, actually we don't feel bad or awkward in saying that we are all slaves of Ishvara. Atman is associated with the quality of the infinite extensiveness in its pristine state. Under the load of karma, it is conditioned to be within the body, the Atman. This condition is only temporary and is true when under a state of bondage. When the Atman is liberated from bondage, it regains an unlimited state, and this reason can be described as Brahman. So Gita Bhashya of the series, this is the first of the Gita Bhashya of Sri Ramanuja. We'll try to understand from Sri Ramanuja's version, commentaries on Bhagavad Gita.